Hi, it's Adrian Fee. How are you doing? And so I went ahead and got a sample of the new bass that I thought I'd go ahead and try. And it's new to me. It's not actually new as far as being out there, but it's a Kosas one. And let's see what I have here. It says that it is a tinted face oil and that the color I have is 03 fair with cool undertones. So again, fair with cool undertones. There we go. And so that's what I have on my face today. And as far as what I noticed with it, it is really extremely oily. But for some of us that are a little older, and our skin is a little drier and such and so forth and everything, it's actually maybe going to be a good alternative. The one thing I noticed when I was actually applying it was the tint was down at the bottom of the sample, so I would suggest shaking it up if you have a bottle, just to make sure that everything gets mixed up, because again, I've got most of my tint down at the bottom, and it didn't realize it's the first time I've ever used it, first time I've ever played with it. So I tried to put on like every single texture that I could find on my face to see if things were going to go ahead and slide off or whatever, and they didn't. So the first one I used was the Cheek Dew by ColourPop, the Kiss Kiss, and this is what I have on my cheeks, and it is a liquid cheek product, and it didn't go ahead and slide off. I think I would have given this a couple more minutes to set. In fact, if and when I go ahead and do this again, first of all, I won't use a lot of face oils before I do it, which actually I didn't do today. But I definitely wouldn't put a lot of face oils underneath this because it has a lot of moisture in it. And then I would let it set for about 15 minutes before I tried to apply any other makeup on there. I was excited, so I was applying all sorts of things. But with the Cheek Dew, I had to put on a couple of layers, and I think that was because I didn't give it enough time to set. I think if I'd given it that 15 minutes, that I would have been able to go ahead and do one coat on the Cheek Dew. I also went ahead and used on my cheeks for the bronzer. This is the Bare Minerals Kiss of Copper. So that's what I have on my cheek. And then as far as the, where did everything go? As far as the bronzer on my forehead and under the chin, I used the Flower Heatwave. And let's see, I also used a combination of that with the Charlotte Tilbury Hollywood Glow Bronzer, so I used that on there as well. I also used a combination of products as far as on the cheeks or on the highlighter side. So I used Seismic, and then I went ahead and used the Sungasm from Catrice, which is this one, and Seismic, which is from ColourPop, and I mixed those two in. And yeah, they definitely stayed on. So yeah, I got glow. They didn't disappear, which was something that I was kind of concerned about. I also used the Charlotte Tilbury powder in Fair One for under the eyes. This is someplace where I think if I was doing it again, let's see. The concealer I used was the Pretty Fresh, and I think if I did it again, I would do one coat of the Pretty Fresh right when I put on the foundation, let it set for about 15 minutes, and then put on another coat. Because I think what saved it, or what gave me the under eye coverage, was actually the powder today. And usually these two work really well together. So, yeah, I think I got some under eye coverage, but I could have definitely built that up by adding another coat if I wanted to. As far as size go, the ColourPop Creamsicle. So I used all four colors in the Creamsicle, the cute little palette. I used this one on my brow, this one in the outer corner, this one in the middle of my lid, and this one on the inside of my lid. So that was so I used all of those, and I think it came out really pretty. And then as far as the eyeliner, what I used was this one. This is actually from the Limoncello. It's one of the matte ones in blue, and that's what I have under my eye. So that's the color right there. My swatch I have on as far as an eyeliner. I think I'll do swatches of the ColourPop here real quick. It's a really pretty palette. So there are the two mattes, and then as far as the two shimmers. So yeah, there are all four colors as far as the swatch. And again, that's what I went ahead and used on my eyes. And then I used the Sky High Mascara and the Volume Stylist. So I used both of these, let's see, yeah, on my eyelashes. As far as my brow tint, I did go ahead and use the Essence. And this was another one of the products that I was really concerned, which is sort of slide off my face with an oil. It just kind of blows me away that there's now a tinted oil. But so this is what I used on my eyebrows. I didn't have any problems. I didn't have any smudging. I didn't have anything like it all going all over everywhere, which is really nice. And then I used the ColourPop Just a Tint in Maui Wowie, and then the ColourPop Ultra Glossy Lip as well. So that's what I have on the lips here. And overall, I'm actually really happy with it. Like I said, you do need to have some time when, or in my opinion, you need to have some time when you go ahead and use this foundation, because you need to let it sink in for about 15 minutes before you put the makeup products over it, because otherwise, well, I mean, like, well, with the cheek product, with the, I had to apply basically three different times. And if I had let it set, I doubt I would have had to do that. But the fact that this oil foundation can actually take a cream blusher is a really good sign. Kind of impressed, really. Kind of impressed. And it has a lot of moisture, and again, for some of those older people that are working with the opposite of, well, I still have combination skin, but it's dry and then it's oily on my T-zone. So it's a very, very oily texture, and it does take that 15 minutes to sink in. But once it does, I put liquid cream cheek over it. I put powder highlighter on there. I put powder eye colors on there. I put bronzer on there. And I did, the eyeliner. And everything's staying. It's not drifting down my face, which, be really scary if it did. It's pretty amazing technology and everything. This is what I ended up with, and I think that's just about all the products that I use. Like I said, I think this is a really good product. It's just a little different to deal with. Shake it up real well, and it's glowy. And like I said, I didn't put on my glowy primer or anything, and it definitely has enough. So it's pretty, and if you want to pick it up, I think probably people who have a little bit more drier skin now, especially with summer, that it would be a good purchase. So thank you and have a good day. Bye.